Namaste everyone. Welcome to Sukshma Shakti for Women Empowerment Series. Hope you all have a wonderful day. Today's topic is going to be how to overcome insecurities. What is insecurity? We get insecure with little things in life, but if we look at the bigger picture, we are here for a shorter term in this world. Life and death are inevitable. Everything is constantly changing. We come alone and we go alone, but yet we get entangled with many things and want more of everything. We also know that things are not permanent either. Wealth, name, fame, property, none of these go with us when we leave this world. Yet we go through so many worries and insecurities, craving for a lot, and compare with one another about what we don't have. Eventually, insecurities trap us in the prison that we create, leading a lot of other problems. We all have some type of insecurities about life and about ourselves. So in today's episodes, let's dive into our own insecurities and find out how Sukshma healing meditation can help us overcome this insecurity to realize the inner security. Let's shift the gears from insecurity to inner security, which is more robust and permanent, which uplifts and keeps us stable always. So what are the causes of insecurities? Lack of true sense of self, not identifying what your inner self is, comparing with others what we don't have versus what we have, and the biggest one, fear of failure, fear of rejection, guilt, past trauma and experiences, lack of trust in self. And these insecurities leads to different outcomes. Let's talk to Sunita about the insecurities which leads to different outcomes.
Hello everyone. Yes, everyone faces insecurities in life. It may be related to work, family, business, or any type of activity. Because of these insecurities, we'll start comparing with others. There we will start having jealous, anger, greed, and anxiety. It will cause unnecessary disturbances and depression, which will affect our health, family, and job life. To overcome this, we need to believe and trust ourselves. That trust and confidence will be developed by following Sukshma meditation. This shows how Sukshma is beneficial for everyone to overcome these insecurities such as jealousy, anger, greed, anxiety, and depression, to reveal our fearless, changeless identities, which is our inner pure self.
Thank you very much, Sunita, for sharing the outcomes of insecurities. Now let's go to Sangeeta she's going to share her experiences of how she overcome the insecurities through Sukshma.
Hello everyone. So as Sunita said, fear is root cause of all insecurities in the mind. There are many types of fear. Fear is losing job, fear of losing friend, family or love, fear of losing wealth and health. Whatever we have acquired so far, root cause of all these fears is only one. It is the biggest fear, death. So mind is monkey, body is water bubble, or they are temporary. They keep changing across the births. Our insecurity comes when we depend on these two. So we need to catch the one that is only secure, unchanging, fearless, and eternal. That is Atman, soul, the pure self. So here, Sukshma helps in removing these insecurities and clean subconscious mind. It reveals our fearless, changeless identity, which is our pure self. So when the mind is clean and clear, there is no chance for insecurity. So mind is polluted because of 6 vices and 5 senses. If we use senses in a positive way, we can feel secure. For example, I can give about ear in the 5 senses. The shape of the ear is like this, and the other side of is like this. If we combine these 2 shapes, it becomes in the form of heart. So if we filter negativity and listen only positivity, pure love will always be present in our heart. And I tell you one story of cow and tiger. One day, cow went to forest. There a tiger attacked this cow. So cow started running, followed by tiger. They ran about a mile. All of a sudden, both fell into mud pond. They are stuck and cannot get out from the mud pond. After some time, cow asked a question to tiger. You are fearless, strong, and fast. Who is your guru? And the tiger laughed and told, I don't have any guru and don't need anyone. Myself is king of this jungle. So cow became silent, and tiger asked some same question to cow. Who is your guru? My owner is my guru. By the time of sunset, he will come for sure to rescue me. If I don't reach my home at the time of sunset, cow owner found this cow and rescued her. So here the story we have. So ignorance as stronger as tiger, cow smooth as the soul. So guru is the owner who saved the cow, and he is our savior by the giving the right knowledge in our lives. So in my life, I had insecurities in my situations, like during the childhood and undergraduate studies, while learning things during study hours or preparing for any competitive exams like and interviews, I had insecurity about my performances. If I think now, study or learning without fear, I would have better results or grades than those. And also in our scriptures, Rama has many mentors, gurus in his life like Vasishta, Vishwamitra. So even Rama felt insecurity at some point of time during the war while fighting with Ravana. Agastya Mahamuni cleared his insecurities and gave him confidence by providing Aditya Hridayam. So likewise, every great person has mentors, gurus in their lives to remove these insecurities and guide to reach the ultimate goals. So I believe strongly in everyone's life, they have to choose guru and follow them to reach higher level in their lives.
Very well said. Excellent. It's beautifully said, Sangeeta. You know, ignorance and fear are the main root cause of insecurities. One has to remove those ignorance and fear and, you know, be grounded and build compassion and love. I think one can, you know, feel secure within, get into the inner secure. Lovely. Thank you very much. Sunita, how did you overcome insecurities through Sukshma? What are your experiences?
I want to share my experience. When I started working, I always used to underestimate my work and had no self-confidence. I always used to doubt myself, even if it's not work-related, I doubted anything I do. After doing Sukshma meditation, I was able to conquer these insecurities. I focus less on the negative thoughts, and I was able to build my self-esteem. I realized that focusing on the past is not beneficial, but cherishing the present moment brings out our identity. Practicing Sukshma meditation helps with this, as it has direct connection to our inner soul. It helps clean the subconscious and get rid of insecurities. And also I want to share my daughter experience. It helped my daughter, Sukshma meditation helped my daughter with this kind of insecurities, especially when she applied for colleges. Teenagers usually stress out when they apply for colleges and feel insecure because of the uncertainty of the acceptance. With my daughter, meditation helped her believe in herself and realize she doesn't need any external validations. Sukshma allows you and us to work like a compass. It will point us to the right direction. In this, it's not about direction, which is not about north, south, east, and west, but it is to your center, your inner self. So always have that inner compass and become a magnet so that it will always point to your center. Sukshma allows you to become that inner magnet. That's all my experiences, Meena, with me and my
very good, wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sunita and Sangeeta, for sharing your experiences of overcoming insecurities. Sukshma gives four simple things to overcome these insecurities. First, affirm your value. Sukshma reveals your priceless possession, which is invaluable. Second one, challenge negative thoughts as they pop. Sukshma develops moment-to-moment awareness so that you can get rid of those doubts and negative thoughts immediately. Do not dwell on the past or worry about the future. Sukshma allows your mind to keep in the present moment, always taking the power from this present, which is now. The fourth one is acceptance of challenging situations. Sukshma builds phenomenal unconditional acceptance no matter what the situation is. See, as Sangeeta told, mind is a monkey. We use logic many times. We wave between thoughts. My challenge used to be about decision making. It used to cause me a lot of uncertainty and fear. I used to use my logical mind always. I used to depend on talking to others for validation. But with Sukshma, now I seek inner wisdom, intuitions, and insights. I go within and into the inner silence. In the inner silence, I see the light that removes insecurity and fear associated with it. I simply meditate whenever I have that insecure feeling. Going deeper, I cross those wavering, insecure thoughts. Intuitions happen only when the mind is silent. That inner intuition removes insecurity caused by the chatter of the minds, the cluttering mind. Sukshma takes us into the stillness and makes our intuition strong, giving that inner security. Let's take baby steps daily. I hope you all enjoyed today's session of insecurities. I hope you shift your gears from insecurities to inner securities. Thank you very much for joining us. Have a good day. Thank you.